In my previous video, I've shown you how to create interesting section breaks using the Dynamo-based library, but this might not always be an ideal option, especially because, well, you don't want to use an entire library, even though it's really small, just to add a little bit of visual flair to your website. There's a better way though, and that is called CSS Clipped. CSS Clipped allows you to hide certain parts of your element and create really interesting shapes. In this video, I'll show you exactly how it works and how you can utilize it to create interesting fluid section breaks. Let's dive right in. All right, we will use the same starting point as before. This simple page with a couple of elements, with a header, a footer, and a couple of elements right here. And we will make those breaks between those sections much more interesting. And this time we will not use a library, but we will use a CSS Clipped property. And CSS Clipped property actually allows you to specify which parts of the element you want to hide. Or rather, you could have an element which are always rectangles on the web, like you see right here, but with the CSS Clipped, you can actually define which part of that element you actually want to show. So in that case, the shape of the element would no longer be rectangle, but something entirely different. You can find the detailed docs here on MDN. And there are a couple of values that Clipped takes, like circle, ellipse, polygon, and path. And we're going to go over some of those interesting ones. And the first one that we're going to try is going to be ellipse, because what I want to do here is I want to make this header section have this beautiful little concave right here, which is actually going to be created with the Clipped ellipse. So to start, let's just copy the value from right here. We're going to paste it into our header directly here. And let's see how this looks. And something happened right here, and it's not what we want, but we can actually tweak it. Now the thing is, if you're working with those numbers right here, it's very difficult to understand what's happening and how you can tweak those numbers to have a shape that you want. So ideally, you would want to use some kind of a graphical UI, and you actually can. Firefox Developer Tools has a fantastic CSS Clipped editor that allows you to tweak exactly this shape that we created right here. And this is only available in the Firefox at the moment. It's not available in Chrome Developer Tools. It's not available in Safari Inspector. So if you want to work with CSS Clipped, I strongly suggest you open up the Firefox Developer Tools and edit them right there. So let's see how this would work. I'm going to open Developer Tools with Command Shift I, and I'm going to select my header element right here. And if you scroll down here, you're going to see there's a Clipped property right here and this little toggle right here. If you click on it, you're going to see that the points in your element appear right here. So you can simply drag and drop them, edit them, and do with them whatever you like you would expect from any kind of graphical software. So I'm going to create something along the concave right here. And as you can see, these parts of element are now hidden, but ideally I would actually want to have a little bit more of an element right here to have a little bit nicer concave. So I'm going to increase padding on my header element. So let's try to do 5 frames. And obviously this was reset to the initial value we had right here. One thing that's not really working ideally is that once you tweak those values in your code, this editor will appear broken. This editor will no longer work, and you're gonna have to refresh your browser page to make it work. It's just something to keep in mind. If Clipped editor stops working, you wanna refresh the browser and re-enable it, and it should be working fine again. So let me just jump back right here to our header element, and let's find our Clipped property, enable the editor, and let's see if it works now. And sure enough, it does. So I'll tweak those points again and have them exactly as I want. And another beautiful thing again here is that you can actually tweak numbers in code to have them exactly at the point where you want, because right here you see it's not exactly in the middle, it's at 47%. So I'm going to switch that to 50, and here I want to switch that to 0% and not to 2%, because it's sometimes really difficult to actually drag those points exactly to the 0 or to 100% or something like that. In any case, we have this shape right here, which looks pretty interesting. Let's see how it behaves if I resize the browser. And obviously it's not ideal. And it's not ideal because we're using the fixed units right here. Pixels, pixels, and here are percentages. So I would like to switch those values to percentages. And if we switch those values to percentages right here in Developer Tools, once you work again with the Clipped editor, it's gonna be tweaking those values in percentages. So let's just try to do 60% here maybe, and 30% for our second point. This is going to look like this, and I can again tweak it as I would like. And there we go. Now we have a beautiful little concave right here. It looks great, and it's actually responsive. So regardless of how you resize the browser, it's going to work as you would expect. So I'm going to copy here this Clipped we created right here and paste it in my code right here to make this change permanent. And I'm gonna save this. And we have our beautiful concave on our header. We can also use polygon function to create interesting shapes. So let's try that. Maybe we want to create not a concave here, but maybe a slanted edge. So let's switch this clip path to polygon. And again, we will just copy the code from this example right here and tweak it in the clip path editor. So I'm going to paste it. And we have a couple of points. Now, if we enable the clip path editor, it's again not going to work because we've tweaked the code here and the developer tools were not refreshed. So that is the bug that I mentioned earlier. So we want to save this and refresh the browser, and then the clip editor should work again. Let me select the header again. And we have our toggle right here. I'm going to click it and there we go. This is actually working. I'm going to adjust those points like this, and we're going to create a slanted edge that looks something like this. And again, you can tweak values directly in code to make them exactly at the point where you want. And we want this at 0 and 0. I'm going to switch this to percentages as well. And this is going to be at 100% and at 0%. And again, we're going to just switch this to 100% and maybe this to 70 to make numbers round. Now our design looks much more interesting, much more dynamic than before. We don't have those straight lines. We have these interesting lines that are really easy to create using the clip pad. I'm gonna paste this code right here to make the change permanent again. And actually I prefer our initial version, so I'm gonna comment this out and let's leave it to our nice little concave. And for next example, let's try to create something a little bit more complex. Maybe we want this element to be a little bit more out of the box. So let's create another polygon. Actually, we're just gonna copy this one and I'm gonna paste it to our hero element. And this immediately applies the same polygon we used before. It's cut off right here. It's not exactly what we want. So again, we're gonna use the clip path editor to tweak those values. And I've applied it to the hero element. So I'm gonna find the clip path here. There we go. And now we wanna create something a little bit more interesting. And right here, I would like to have more points to be able to additionally tweak the shape. And in the clip editor in Firefox, you can easily do that if you just double click somewhere along the edge of an element. It's actually really difficult to pinpoint the place where you can add a point, so you have to really carefully select it. And if you double click on it, you're gonna be able to add another point. And now we can tweak this element a bit more. The thing that I'm doing here might not be an excellent design choice, but it can serve as an example. And if for some reason there's not enough room for your content because it's cut off by the shape, you can always increase the padding or make the element a little bit bigger to give it a little bit more breathing room. So now we created something really out of the box, really strange. It's not ideal for this design, but the purpose, of course, is just to show you what's possible with the clip pad and clip pad editor. So I'm gonna copy this code right here and paste it to my hero selector. All right. And lastly, we wanna add additional shape to our footer. And for this example, I would like something a lot more interesting, something a lot more fluid. I don't want this straight edges that we created with the polygon, but I actually want a nice curve that's not as simple as this one right here. So let's see how we can create this. Option in clip path is actually a path. And as you can see, you have this nice little concave right here. So we can add this to our code and see what happens. I'm gonna find our footer element right here. And I'm gonna add this clip path specified right there with this path. And let's see how it looks. Not ideal. And if we select the footer here element again and look at the clip path, you're gonna see that actually you cannot edit in Firefox the clip path that is defined as a path. But what we can do is we can jump into any graphical editing software, create a shape, export it as SVG, and then use that in our code with the URL syntax for our clip path that references an SVG clip path element. And we're gonna see how this looks really soon. But first, let's create an interesting shape in our graphical editing software. And I'm gonna use Figma to create this. So let's switch to Figma. And let's use the path tool and create a couple of points. This is gonna be some kind of a wave right here. And we have this interesting shape that we wanna use for our clip path. So I'm gonna right click here and I'm gonna select copy as SVG. And I'm gonna switch back to Firefox here. I'm gonna just paste everything that we copied right here into CSS to see what we're dealing with. We actually copied the entire SVG element along with the height and the width and the view box and all of that, and with the path. So if we copy this, and I'm actually gonna comment this out so it doesn't break our CSS. And if we add this to our path right here, let's see what happens. And we actually did create a nice little clip pad, but the problem is this one is defined with a fixed point, which means it's not responsive, it doesn't take the full width of the page. So ideally we want to stretch this to the entirety of our element. To do this, we actually want to turn this absolute points into relative points. And there's a handy tool on the web called clip pad converter, which actually allows you to paste in the absolute clip pad, and it's going to generate a relative clip pad. So I'm going to paste my clip pad right here, and I'm going to copy this generated code right here. And if I paste this as is to my pad, it's not going to work. It's not going to work because it's missing quite a bit. So what I actually want to do, I want to actually copy the entire SVG along with the clip pad that's defined inside. And as we've seen in the documentation right here, you can use the URL that references SVG clip pad, which is exactly going to be the element that has been generated right here. And you can see preview how this would look in our example. So let's go back to our code and let's paste our SVG we copied to our HTML right here to the bottom. And it's gonna have the class of SVG, and we're gonna give it ID of clip. And now, if we switch back to CSS, reference that clip that we defined right here with the URL, it has ID clip, so I'm gonna enter this right here, and let's see our footer. And sure enough, we actually created the shape that we wanted, but we have this empty space right here, and if I inspect this, you're gonna see that this is actually SVG element that we added right there. We actually wanna hide this using the position absolute. Let me just remove this SVG code we pasted a little bit earlier, and let's paste our SVG with the position absolute and the width and height of 0, and you're gonna see that this actually disappeared, and we only have our footer. We need a little bit more padding top here to make it look good, so let's try 15 and see what happens. All right, now we have this really interesting shape. It's fluid, and if I resize the browser, it should resize as well. So in this video, I've shown you how to create interesting shapes using the clip pad editor in Firefox, or how to use the graphical editing software like Figma or Photoshop or anything that you want. Export that image as SVG. If you have that option in your software, maybe you can immediately export it as relative coordinates. If you don't have, there's a handy tool on the web, clip pad converter, that allows you to paste in your absolute pad, and it's gonna convert it to the relative pad that you can use with your SVG. And it's gonna spit out the code right here, SVG and CSS, that you can directly use in your code and make your designs a little bit nicer, a little bit more fluid, a little bit more interesting. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I hope you found this helpful. I hope you start using ClipPath, and I will see and hear you in the next video.